Hi, this is Andy from the Online Learning Department, and in this video, I want to give you a quick overview of the My Home page that comes up when you first log into Desire to Learn. Okay, so we're going to start at the top here on this gray bar that's called the home base. All the way to the left, there's this My Home link. So anytime you click on this, will take you back to this main page in Desire to Learn from wherever you're at in your courses. All right. The next over says select a course. So there, if you click on it, it'll give you a drop-down menu of courses that you're already working in. But this will only be courses that have already started. If you've registered for a course but hasn't started yet, it's not going to appear here. It'll appear when your class begins, okay? Going over to the right side of the home base bar, this first icon is an icon that looks like an envelope, and that's where you're going to get your Desire to Learn email, inside the Desire to Learn email system, which is separate from the email system that your main email and your eWolf account, all right? And notice that it has a red dot on the envelope. Whenever you see a red dot, that means you have a new email that you haven't read yet. So when you see that red dot, you want to go in there and check your email and see what's new, all right? Next over is an alert icon, and this alert icon is messages from the college that are important that you're going to want to know. Like, for example, school is closed today because of weather, or there's going to be a Desire to Learn is going to be down this coming Sunday, things like that. So you want to make sure and check here whenever you see a red dot on the alerts. Next over is the subscriptions icon. We don't use subscriptions at Front Range, so you don't have to worry about it. And over here to the farthest to the right is a place where you can set up a profile of yourself, just like you would on Facebook or something else like that. So you can put in a picture and some information about yourself, but that's totally optional. You don't have to do that if you don't want to, all right? So next, I want to go to the left-hand column here that's under this news label. And this is used, these news items are used by the college to give you information and updates. Like this one has some information on the Turnitin program that's used for submitting assignments, some changes in some of the basic things that are in D2L. So you always want to look at these and see what's new and make sure that you're up to date on what's going on in the D2L system and at the college, all right? Once you get down a little further, you're going to get to this My Courses heading. And this is where your courses will actually show up. So when you register for a class, it's going to show up here. And but the link won't be active till the day the course starts. You can't get into the courses early. So on the day your courses start, you can click on the links for any of the courses, and it'll take you into the course. Also here, besides your courses, you'll also see a link to the Student Union, and you'll see a link to the Introduction to Online Learning. That if you're new to taking online classes at Front Range, you need to complete before you can start on your first class, okay? In the right-hand column, if we go back up here, I want to bring your attention to this helpful information box right here. This shows you the number for the 24/7 help desk. That is tech folks that will help you with basic technical questions. You can call them any time of day or night, okay? In the next section here, where it says Online Learning Office, this is our phone numbers and email address for the staff in the Online Learning Department that you can get a hold of us during business hours. You can send us an email anytime and we'll get back to you. And any questions you have at all that have to do with online learning, online classes, please call us or write us and we'll do our best to help you out. That's what we're here for. So don't hesitate if something comes up and you have any questions, okay? I think this takes care of everything I wanted to show you. Please, once you're finished with this, you can go on to the next topic. And in the meantime, I hope that this has been useful for you.